For years now, people have asked the question, can the Bible be trusted? The Bible that contains 66 books, written by 44 authors over a 1500-year time period. Many are still asking the question, can this Bible be trusted? Stay with me. I want to give you 5 reasons why you and I can trust the Bible. Number 1. Because of prophecy. Yes, Micah 5 and verse 2 tells us the birthplace of where Jesus would even be born. The Bible throughout tells us that famine and pestilences and earthquakes would take place in a way like never before. Jesus prophesied in Matthew. And we today have seen these things being fulfilling. So much different prophetic messages that were given in the Old Testament that we see being fulfilled in the New Testament. We also see some of them being fulfilling in the Old Testament as well, like kings, where God prophesied that a king would come down and Medo-Persia would come and rule. And we did see that take place even just right there in the book of Daniel. You will see some prophetic themes that fulfilled to the T right there, and also are found in historical books evidencing, showing that these things really took place in history. These are prophecies found in the Bible that God told us about that will take place in the future, and they did come to pass. And many such things that Jesus himself prophesied as well while he was on earth that we see now fulfilling right before our eyes. So prophecy is one evidence why we can trust the Bible. Number 2, we can trust the Bible because of archaeology. Throughout the years, archaeological findings have been discovered. And these archaeological findings also tell us that the Bible can be trusted, like the Moabite stone. We have that. We have also the Rosetta Stone. We have the Lachish letters. We have also the Dead Sea Scrolls. These are evidences that tell us within them that the Bible can be trusted. The Moabite Stone, it was discovered in 1868 at Dibon, Jordan, confirming Moabite attacks on Israel as recorded in 2 Kings chapter 1 and chapter 3. The Lachish letters, discovered 1932 to 1938, 24 miles north of Beersheba, describing the attack of Nebuchadnezzar on Jerusalem in 586 BC. The Dead Sea Scrolls were discovered in 1948. They date back to 150 to 170 BC and contain all or parts of the Old Testament books except the book of Esther. They confirm the Bible's accuracy, friends. Cyrus's cylinder records Cyrus's overthrow of Babylon and his subsequent deliverance of the Jewish captives. Archaeology, they're showing us that these are evidences that the Bible is indeed true. It can be trusted. And also the Rosetta Stone. The Rosetta Stone was discovered in 1799 in Egypt by Napoleon's scientists. It was written in 3 languages, hieroglyphics, Demotic, and Greek. It locked the mystery of understanding hieroglyphics helps to confirm the authenticity of the Bible, my friends. And so these are just some evidences found in archaeology and many more things that we have found in archaeology that tell us as well that the Bible can indeed be trusted. It can be trusted. Number 3, the cohesive unity of the Bible. You know that over 3,000 places in the Bible or occurrences, we will see that the Bible telling us that it's an inspired book that God inspired the Bible. He inspired men to write the Bible. God breathed. God gave the instructions of the Bible. And we have the Bible today because of God. God is the author of the Bible. And we have that cohesiveness seen throughout the entire Bible, pointing to God, giving us the words in the Bible through holy men of God. Number four, it's accuracy as well. Certainly, it is inconceivable that a book so accurate through the centuries could be considered anything less than inspired by God. No man could have written such a beautiful book, my friends, which is so accurate. Like, for instance, God prophesied one thing and it just came right to pass. For instance, as well, it tells us a date when something took place, and just as how the Bible records it, it actually took place. And this Bible is written over a 1500 year time period, and yet still what Moses wrote lines up with what Paul writes, what Moses wrote, or what even David wrote, or Daniel, lines up with what John writes in Revelation. It's so accurate that these different men writing the Bible, but yet still sticking to the theme and sticking to what each other said. This is impossible with just human beings' mind. They should have made a mistake. I'm telling you, men alone, they would have made a mistake. But because the divine hand of God was in it, in producing the Bible, that's why it is accurate. It is accurate. That's number four. And number five, Christ is revealed in the Bible throughout the book of the Old Testament, and also the books of the New Testament. We will see Christ being revealed. This is a beautiful picture of the Bible, that all of these 44 authors, they are pointing to Jesus. We learn principles and lessons that talk about Jesus, and Christ is being revealed as the supreme being who loves you and loves me. And also, while Christ is being revealed in the lives of these individuals in the Bible, Christ is also being revealed in individual lives today. And so this is one of the reasons why many of us as well have even come to know Christ and believe Christ, because we have experienced him on a personal level as well, where Christ took us who were broken and sinful and messed up and gave us a new heart, transformed our lives. He transformed our talk. He transformed our walk and everyday aspect of how we deal with humanity. When doctors could not help us, Christ helped us. When we could not receive healing from somewhere else, Christ healed us. These are even personal evidences that Christ, my friends, he is the one who is revealed in the Bible, that is revealed in our lives as well. And that's an evidence that the Bible can be trusted. He can be trusted. So you and I can rest assured that what we read in scriptures, they are not fairy tales, but they are actually inspired scriptures of Jesus Christ himself, so that we can know how to operate right here on earth every day in our marriages, in our finances, how we interact with humanity, so that we can live an abundant life in Christ as we're heading to glory. I hope this was a blessing to you. So be reminded to subscribe as well to this channel and like, share, and I'll see you next time in the next video. I would love you to become a member here on this channel through subscription. God bless you. Love you always.